हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी आर रिकैप्चुलेट आवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक्स, सो वी विल टेक फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन एंड दैट इज चेंजिंग ट्रेंड्स एंड करियर्स इन फिजिकल एजुकेशन. इन दिस चैप्टर we are come to know about the five objectives, that is meaning and definition of physical education, aims and objectives of physical education, career options in physical education, competition in various sports at national and international level, and the last is Khelo India program. So proceeding further, first today we will cover meaning and definition of physical education and aims and objectives of physical education. First we will give you the introduction. The concept of physical education is not new. In fact, physical education has its roots in the ancient period, although it was used in various form in the past. Its meaning was different to different people. The term physical education is indeed complex and broad-based. It includes many types of phenomenon. In the beginning, physical education was used in the term of physical activities because physical education was essential for people to survive. But the main stress on physical education was laid down in ancient Greece. Philosophers like Socrates, Aristotle, and Plato were of the opinion that physical training is a must for youth. Even in India, physical activities were the essential part of life. In ancient times, the meaning of physical education changed many times during various civilizations. Generally, it has been misunderstood. Someone was of the view that physical education is whatever physical education do. They are thinking that physical education is whatever physical educators do. Sometimes it was confused with physical training, play games, physical culture, health education, and recreation. But as a matter of fact, it is more than these terms. So this is the introduction. In this, they are saying that physical education has this vast area. Still, people are thinking that physical education is what a physical educators do. Playing games, training, physical activities, physical culture, health education, recreation. It's all about physical education. No. The area of physical education is very vast. and it is changing, it is improving day by day. So it is an important part of our life nowadays, because it is very important. And it is not like earlier, it was a perception that physical education is only playing, only sweating, only physical work. But it is not like that. Physical education has some of whole education. If the CBSC and Director of Education keeping it as an important subject, keeping it in a curriculum, so they are thinking, because it is a important part of our life. It is an important part because the trends are changing nowadays. So our trend, our physical education trend is also changes, and it is changing in a positive way. That's why physical education has a vast and changing trends now, and most of the people are adopting, are accepting, are taking it as a career, as a profession, as a lifetime change in their life. So it plays an important role in everyone's life. So don't think that it is just a game, just a play. It is not just a play, it is not just a training, it is not just a physical activity, it is not just a sweat, it is not just a fatigue. It is a science that includes everything. And if you are taking physical education, you are studying physical education, and through physical education, the improvement is holistic. It's overall improvement. That person is physically fit, mentally alert, socially adjustable, emotionally fit. So it is not about playing, it is not about physical fitness, it is all about holistic development of an individual. So it is very important, and if you are indulging in physical education, you are taking it as a subject, so you will come to know about the importance, about the importance in your life. So don't take it as a fifth subject or an additional subject. Take it as a change in your life, and it will definitely make a change in your life. Now, proceeding further, we will discuss about the meaning and definition of physical education. Different people have different education in different ways. A few of these definitions by some eminent people are: first is H.C. Buck. First definition is quoted by H.C. Buck. Physical education is the part of general education, is a part of general education program which develops, which is considered with growth, development and education of children through the medium of big muscle activities. It is the education of whole child by means of physical activities. Physical activities are the tools. They are so selected and conducted as to influence every child's life physically. mentally, emotionally, and morally. So these are the words by H.C. Buck. He thinks that physical education is considered as a development by which a general education program in which it considered with growth and development, and they think that it is a part of education of a children. Through this medium, they think that the big muscle activities are involved, and they think it is education of whole child by the means of physical activities. That means if a child is involved in physical activities, so our teacher will study the whole child. And they also think that the physical activity are the tool. Which tool? By which we can choose, we can select, or we can judge the whole child. They also said that the selected and the conducted to influence every child's. They are selected the child in which perspective? Physical, mental, emotional, and moral. So these are the five perspectives by author, which name is Mr. H.C. Buck. So next author is C.A. Butcher. He said an integral part of total education process, which has its aim the development of physically, mentally, emotionally, and socially effective, the medium of physical activities which have been selected with the variation of those outcomes. So H.C. Butcher said that the physical education is an integral part of education process, by this process we can resolve our aim, we can get our aim through development of physical, mental, emotional, and social. He is saying that if a child is involved in physical education program, so he or she will be fit by physical, mental, emotional, and social. And he also said that it is a medium of physical activity which I have been selected for the variety of outcomes. So these are the words by H.C.A. Butcher. Now we will discuss D. Obstufer. Physical education is the sum of those experiences which come to an individual through movement. That means physical education, you will come to understand when you are involved physically. That means you are not getting it until you are not doing it. So it is the sum of those experiences which come to an individual through movement. until you will not doing it, you will not get the experience of physical education. So it is the perfect definition by D. Obstufer that the physical education is the sum of those experiences which come to an individual through movement. Now next definition is by Cassidy. Physical education is the sum of changes in the individual caused by experiences centering motor activity. So he is saying that it is the change. It is a physical education is the change, a sum of change in individual which is caused by motor activities. Or it is experienced by centering motor activities. Next definition quoted by J.B. Nash. Physical education is that phase of the whole field of education that deals with big muscles activity and their related responses. He is trying to say that the physical education is that phase in which they are in that phase where the whole field of education that deals with the big muscle, that he trying to say that the physical education is deals with the big muscles and their related responses. So it is not, it is a part of like big muscles and study of big muscles and how it can relate it to the responses. It is a part of physical education, but it is not only, it's all about physical, it's not about physical education. As I have already told you that physical education has a vast field, has a vast area. So that big muscle activities and their related responses are the part of physical education, but big muscles activity and the responses are not only a part of physical education. But the definitions are like I will give you one example, that the half a glass is half of water, and some people are saying the glass is half empty, and some are saying the glass is half filled. So it's their opinion, and every individual has their own opinion about some particular thing. So it is also applied in this also. Next definition is by J.F. William and C.L. Brownell. They said that the physical education is the sum of men's physical activities selected as the kind and conducted as to outcomes. That means they are trying to say that physical education is the sum of men's physical activity, whatever activities they are doing, and those selected activities as a kind of conducted as to outcomes. That means they are doing that activities which are conducted for outcomes. So these are the words by J.F. William and C.L. Brownell, that the physical education is the sum of men's physical activities selected as to kind and conducted as to outcome. They are selected for kind and conducted for outcome. So it's their view. Next definition by C.C. Cowell. He said Physical education is the social process of change in the behavior. So, physical education is a change in behavior of human organism originating primarily from the stimulus of social, big muscles, play, and related activities. So this definition is quoted by C.C. Cowell. He said the physical education is a social process of changes in the behavior, and the changes of behavior in human organism originating primarily from the stimulus of social, big muscles, play, and related activities. Next definition by C.L. Brownell. Physical education is the accumulation of wholesome experiences through participation in large muscle activities that promote optimum growth and development. So C.L. Brownell trying to say that the physical education is the accumulation of wholesome experience. That means physical education gives you the wholesome experience through participating. When you are participating in physical education program, so you will give the wholesome experience. You will get the wholesome experiences. And what wholesome experiences? The experience in large muscles activities. And these large muscles activities promote the optimum growth and development. That means they are trying to say that the whatever activities are done by the large muscles activities, and whatever activity are done by the large muscles activity, and those large muscles activity will promote the optimum growth and development. And so according to him, this is physical education is. Now, according to the Central Advisory Board of Physical Education and Recreation, what he is trying to say that physical education is the education, it is the education through physical activities for the development of the total personality of the child to its fullness and perfection in body, mind, and spirit. That means they are trying to say that the physical education is the education in which the child is getting the education of physical activities, and through physical activity, what are the total development of the personality of the child will affect by physically, mentally, and spiritually. So these are the thinking about physical education by Central Advisory Board of Physical Education and Recreation. In the light of above definitions, it can be said that physical education is an integral part of general education, and it is essential for human beings. It is not merely a physical activity, but it is the education of the body through the body. American research studies shows that the person who were engaged in various programs of physical education achieved higher goal in their lives in comparison to those who did not indulge in physical activities. In fact, physical education enables a child to have total physical growth and development to lead a happy and prosperous life. Finally, it can be concluded that physical education not only helps in physical development, but it also helps in mental, social, and emotional development of an individual. So, in the conclusion, it can be said that the summarization of all the definitions are in one paragraph, and it is likely to be said that the physical education is an integral part of general education, and it is essential for human being, and it is not merely a physical activity, but it is an education of the body through body. So physical education is an education through body to body. All many researches are done for under physical education and for physical education, which studies shows that the person who were engaged in various programs of physical education achieved higher goal in their lives in comparison to those who are not involved or those who are not indulged in physical activities. So the person who is physically involved in physical education programs is achieving the higher goal in their lives in comparison to the person who is not indulged in physical activities. And physical education enables the child to have total physical growth and development. That physical education helps the child to grow and develop their total, the wholesome development of personality. So it is enables the child to have total growth and development, which lead to happy and prosperous life. So it helps to lead a happy and prosperous life for a child, for a human being. And at the last, it can be said that the physical education is not only help in physical development, but it is also help in mental, social, and emotional development of an individual. So we can say that, as I have already explained you earlier, that the physical education helps in the overall development of an individual. It will helps you to develop the individual or child's holistic development. And it is very important, and it is very vast, and it has an important part of everyone's life nowadays. So, in conclusion, we can say that the physical education not only helps the individual, helps the person by physically development, but also helps in mental, social, and emotional development of an individual. So that's all for the day, and we have completed our first topic, that is meaning and definition of physical education, and we have discussed all the definitions by different writers. So just go through it and prepare a note. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.